So guys, we'll start about the anatomy of abdomen now, a new topic, abdominal anatomy. Very important, lot of questions from here. So first of all, we have to know the layers in the abdomen. If I am cutting my abdomen from the lateral side, what we are seeing? First what we'll cut the skin. First of all, we'll cutting the skin. Then we have fascia there. Which is fascia? Superficial fascia. First we'll cut the skin, we are moving toward superficial fascia. Then you can see fats there, membranous and soft and spongy fat. So they are having a specific name. This is also asked in MCQ. Remember, superficial fascia include two layers again, camper and scarpa. Remember, camper means soft and spongy fat, and scarpa means membranous. Remember it. And after that, we'll see the muscles. We'll go with external oblique. First external side, then we have internal oblique. Then we have transverse abdominals, then we have fascia, transversalis fascia, last we are moving toward peritoneum, right? Now, remember there is a very important question here, internal oblique and transverse abdominalis, that is IO plus TA, we call it other as conjoint tendon. See, if this is my rough figure, this is our abdomen. There are muscles here, you can know serratus anterior and transverse abdominalis, internal oblique. This is internal oblique and transverse abdominis. See, internal oblique, the main part is the upper neurosis part. So this together we are going as what? Conjoint tendon. Very important MCQ. Now we have some muscle here, pyramidalis. You can see this is anterior superior iliac spine. This is our pubic tubercle. So this is our inguinal ligament. And we have muscle here, pyramidalis. Pyramidalis, and we have rectus abdominis muscle. I am marking here. See, rectus abdominis. The abdomen region, rectus abdominis muscle. So, the rectus abdominis plus pyramidalis, they form a sheath. That sheath is called rectus sheath. So, very important. So, how rectus sheath is formed? Combination of rectus abdominis and pyramidal muscle. They combine to form what? Rectus sheath. Now they will ask you, what are the contents in the rectus sheath? So there is a separate question, that is contents of this rectus sheath. First of all, we know, so I am talking about contents of rectus sheath. Okay, contents. We already know rectus sheath, they are made up of which muscle? Rectus abdominis and pyramidalis. Now there are some vessels here. We have superior epigastric vessel and inferior epigastric vessel. Inferior epigastric. See, the contents include rectus abdominis and pyramidalis and superior epigastric and inferior epigastric. See, this superior epigastric is a branch of musculophrenic artery, musculophrenic, and that is a branch of what? Internal thoracic. That is a branch of internal thoracic. Remember, superior epigastric vessel, that is a branch of musculophrenic artery, and that is a branch of internal thoracic. Now inferior is a branch of inferior epigastric vessel, it's a branch of external iliac. External iliac. So, also asked. See, contents include rectus abdominis and pyramidalis. Contents of rectus sheath we are talking. Rectus sheath means a combination of rectus abdominis and pyramidalis. The contents include the muscles here, then superior epigastric vessel and inferior epigastric vessel. Superior epigastric is a branch of muscular phrenic artery, and that is a branch of internal thoracic artery. Now, inferior epigastric is a branch of external iliac artery. So, also asked in many MCQ. And there are some nerves here. Lower 6 thoracic spinal nerves. Other contents include contents first 2 and 3rd. Lower 6 thoracic spinal nerves. So listen here once again, we were talking the important part of abdomen. See, in abdomen, if I am cutting the abdomen from, so they will ask you in order 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and they will interchange the order and ask. So if I cut my abdomen, first I am cutting skin, then I am saying superficial fascia. It includes camper and scarpa. Camper means soft and spongy fat. Scarpa means membranous part. Then we have external oblique. That is mainly the aponeurosis, we have internal oblique, then transverse abdominis. See, internal oblique and transverse abdominis together they will form a tendon, that is called what? Conjoint tendon. We have transversal fascia, then we have peritoneum. That is the layer in order, remember it. Now, remember the rectus abdominis, the rectus, the six pack muscle of us, right? Six pack muscle of us together with the pyramidal muscle here, they together form rectus sheath. So rectus sheath, they are having some other contents. They are having superior epigastric vessel and inferior epigastric vessel. Superior epigastric vessel is a branch of musculophrenic artery, and that is a branch of internal thoracic artery. Now, inferior epigastric artery, that is a branch of external iliac. Remember, that is a branch of external iliac. Now we have other contents like lower six thoracic spinal nerves. They are also in what? Rectus sheath. So they are having muscle, vessels and nerves. So that's all about brief introduction about abdomen. Okay?